let's say your boss wants you to run half inch EMT from this box right here over to this box right here. And he wants you to make it look professional. And to top it off, he only gives you one piece of EMT. That's it. There's no more EMT around for miles. So, and he's gonna give you 15 minutes. So what do you do? If you've been watching my channel, take a break for 5 minutes. It's not gonna take you that long. Seriously. So we're gonna start right here. We're gonna have to have a box offset going right here. It'll be a 3/8 inch box offset with two 10 degree bends, okay? And then we're gonna run into this 2-inch rigid conduit right here. This is non-metallic rigid conduit. And we're gonna have to jump over this with a 3-point saddle bend. Okay, we'll get to that in a minute. And then we're gonna have to keep everything to make it look professional. Right? The boss said make it look professional. So we're gonna have to keep our conduits parallel to these other conduits. See, there's a 2-inch spacing between each one, and they all go concentric is the word with each other. We just call them parallel EMT bends. And so it's gonna have to go nice and level with these conduits. And when you get over here, we're gonna have to have a nice 90 degree bend that looks concentric with these 90 degree bends. And then we're gonna need another box offset 10 degrees and 10 degrees, jumping up 3/8 of an inch to get to this box. So let's get started. The first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna cheat. I'm just kidding, we're not really gonna cheat, but we're gonna use a green cross line laser level. This one is made by Dewalt. It's a 12 volt max tool. And there's a green line right here. I can see it plainly. And so I'm gonna make little marks right here. This is 2 inches from here. And I'll just make little cheap marks here. A big advantage to using these laser levels is that you can jump over obstacles like this and, you know, get your line continuing like that. So here's our line right here. The unit's right here. It's right here. This laser level is a cross line laser level. So we have a cross right here. So we're going over this way. And then it also shows you up this way. This is plumb, it's a plumb line. This is a level line. So I've made little marks here right on the green lines going this way and going this way. So that gives us a head start. So we got our line plotted out this way and we have our line plotted out that way. You don't have to use a laser for this layout, but if you have one, go for it. It's great. It makes everything nice and level and plumb. So we're gonna start with the first box offset going to the first box. This right here is an arbitrary amount. I've used 2 inches. You could use 2.5 or 3 inches, but I've chosen 2. And then this distance right here is figured out with something called a multiplier. We're going to be using 10 degree bends, and the multiplier is 6. And we're going to be jumping up 3/8 of an inch off the board to get to the first box. So 3/8 of an inch times 6 is 2.25. So we have 2.25 inches right here between these bends. So this will be a 10 degree bend, and this will be a 10 degree bend going in the 180 degree opposite direction. Here we have the conduit at my first mark, lining up with the arrow of the bender. And the first bend is going to be right here to 10 degrees. So I'm gonna put my boot on the bottom of the handle of the bender, and we're gonna go right down to 10 degrees, just like that. Then I'm gonna take it, spin it 180 degrees, and once again, I'm going to line up my mark on the arrow of the bender. I'm gonna sight down, make sure I'm in the same plane. That looks quite nice right there. So we got the arrow on the second mark, and once again, we're going to go to 10 degrees. I put my boot on the bottom of the handle of the bender, and there you go. That's your first box offset. Now we're going to work on the three-bend saddle, which is the bend that goes over this obstacle. So if I put my tape right here about where the conduit is going to end, it's going to go into this fitting about that far. And you make the measurement, and there it is, 33 inches. So that's where we're going to start, but you got to add on the shrink. The shrink is 3/16 of an inch per inch of height. Now I want to mention, we're going to make the first bend is going to be 22.5 degrees. The second bend in the middle here is going to be 45, and the next bend is going to be 22.5 degrees. So what we use for the shrink is actually the shrinkage for a 22.5 degree bend. And the shrinkage for a 22.5 degree bend is 3/16 of an inch per inch of height of obstruction. So this is about 2.5 inches, and we're going to want to clear it by 1/2 inch. So we're going to say 3 inches. And the shrink is 3/16 of an inch per inch of height of obstruction, with the obstruction being 3 inches. So that's 3 × 3/16 is 9/16. So we have the 33, but then it's going to shrink before it gets here. So we've got to add on 9/16 for the shrink. So our middle bend is going to be 33 9/16. So here's our middle bend at 33 9/16. Now we got two bends, one on either side of the middle bend. Now how do we know where to put these marks? Here it is right here. The outer marks are 2.5 inches per inch of height of obstruction. And you can find this on tables. I'll give you a link in my video description for a real good table that will give you this. It's 2.5 inches per inch of height of obstruction, with the obstruction being 3 inches. So our marks on either side of the middle mark are going to be 7.5 inches. This is our middle mark with the shrink figured in, and then you just go 2.5 inches × 3 this way, and 2.5 inches × 3 this way, 7.5 inches both ways. You put the middle mark that we made on the conduit on the notch of the bender. This notch is only used for the middle bend of a three-bend saddle. So we put the middle bend right here on the notch, and we're going to go to 45 degrees right here. And it doesn't matter which way you have the bender turned. You just put it on the notch and it'll be right. Just make this bend to 45 degrees. Okay, I have the notch on the middle mark of the conduit. And I've got our box offset aligned in the same plane. Okay, so it goes right like that. Double check everything. Okay, so we're gonna bend it down to 45 degrees. Put your boot on the bottom of the handle of the bender. So we're going to right here. Okay. So now it would push it through. And we're going to go to the arrow, and we're going to 22.5. Okay, then you spin it around, take it out, put it right in, put your line on the arrow, and we're going to 22.5 degrees. All right, there you go. So far we have a box offset right here, and you go straight down. You have a 22.5 degree bend, a 45 degree bend, a 22.5 degree bend, and that's a three point saddle band, and then it's going to go on the wall like this, and then it's going to go down, and at some point this has to turn up. We have to do a 90 degree right here. So that's the next thing we're going to do. We have five conduits, all in parallel, all concentric. This is the innermost one, and this is 90 degree bend, and we're going to be bending on the star, not on the arrow. I'll show you that in a second. Okay, so the first conduit here we bent at 68 and 7/16, and each one successively is 2 inches longer. We have a 2-inch spacing and a 90 degree bend, so you just add 2 inches to the length of each one. This figure right here is the fourth conduit. So we bent that at 74 and 7/16. So the one that we're doing right now will be the fifth one. So this is the bend we're doing right now. It's 2 inches longer than the previous one. So we're going to be bending on the star at 76 and 7/16. And the stub lengths are also 2 inches longer each time successively. So this is the fourth one right here. This stub right here rose 36 and 5/16. So our stub will have to rise 38 and 5/16. According to our calculations, we need to make this mark at 76 and 7/16. Okay, with the other bends flat on the floor, we're gonna bend this conduit 90 degrees straight up. See, it has to all be in the correct plane. So we're going straight up right here, bending on the star. Here's the star right here. We're gonna bend on the star as opposed to the arrow so that we only have to make one mark. It's just a little quicker that way. So we're gonna bend a 90 degree stub in the correct plane with the star. Then let's go ahead and step on the conduit. That should be 90 degrees right there. With your boot on the conduit, we're going to measure up 38 and 5/16 right here. And go ahead and ream it. Okay, let's see what she looks like. We'll put it in this one first. Right in there. Tighten this down with a number 2 square. And over here, put that in. Oh, this is lined up perfectly. This line is lined up with that just perfectly. All right, we got a nice 2-inch differential there. Look at our cheat lines. Yeah, they're right on the money. That's good. Okay, so now we're gonna put on one hole straps, making sure the conduit is right on our cheat line. Here's the box offset that we started off with, 10 degrees and 10 degrees, and then we jump over here to the obstacle, which was the 2-inch rigid non-metallic conduit, and you see our middle mark lines up perfectly with the middle of the conduit. And then here's the other two marks right here. We go around, let's see, it looks, the spacing looks good. All right, the concentric nature of the 90s looks good. And we come right up, and there's our box offset again. So that looks good. So there it is, that's the box offset, the 90, the 3-point saddle bend, and the last box offset. I'll put a link in my video description for the DeWalt 12 volt max 5 spot plus cross line green laser level. I'll put a link for the Milwaukee 3¼-inch compact M18 bandsaw. I'll put links for the Ideal Benders, both in aluminum and in malleable iron. I'll put a link for the Klein 5167 tool pouch, the Klein reamer, the Klein lighted level and the brand new Klein laser line bubble level. Thanks. I hope this video was helpful.